So we're gonna take the center console out and move the seat all the way forward. Looks like the squid's gonna come out too. Okay, so these six guys, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the other side, they go down. And then these two guys right here, they slide out. There we are. Tuck it back in there. All right. There it is. All right, so white clips, we got 1, 2, 3, 4 missing. That was 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right, so the remaining thing we got going on, 2 bolts. So this guy, kind of looks like a self-tapper. He goes up top, and then this guy with the lighter color goes on the bottom. Both are 10 millimeter. Okay, this bottom one right here. So, bottom one in that hole. These top guys right here, this one and this one, those are beasts. And then this is like a female slot, but pulls back just like the opposite side. And everything with the white clip, those can just go out with a little less force, one at a time. Okay, so I pop them back. Give us any more slack. That guy down. Slide that thing back. And there he is right there. So at this point, I think all we're doing is we're just sliding the whole thing up and back. Up and out. There's a handy handhold there, actually. Thank you. All right, so we got our plate in short order, base plate for our handbrake. And according to my CAD, this guy will actually just slip right in there. Yes. Oop, drops right in. Check that fit. No gaps around the sides. Still gonna get some little spacers underneath the front. Weld nuts around the perimeter. The weld nuts are gonna have custom washers that actually fit in these little square or rectangular holes right there. That'll be your drill guide to actually make a hole for the fastener through the plastic. But then there's no tool required on the inside because as we saw, there's actually just like a totally flat top on that plate. So the weld nut on the inside will just have you using a socket on the outer holes, which we also measured to make sure that you can actually like get it in there. It didn't have any holes in the top, but it definitely will once we figure out the optimum position. Factory busted this out immediately. Totally appreciate that. I think it's the AC vent that was stopping me. You can see it from this area on the other side. Yeah. There we are.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
So now we can see that it's actually up underneath that notch. It just slides right in there. Let's see how he fits in there. Ooh. This might be a little tough. Yep, we actually made it. And I'm gonna adjust this angle. Anything touching at the top? My arm is rubbing this seat bolster at around the same time that my elbow's touching down, so I feel like that's pretty good. I'm gonna put that thing in there completely straight. So wearing a helmet on track definitely does work with the seat laid back. And as we can see, it's also working with the side bolster. That feels really good to me. With the seat bottom up and with the back kind of like laid back, I'm not even slamming the center console at all. In addition to all that, this is actually an adjustable handbrake handle. 30 millimeters on there. Move our locking collars up. The whole point of a handbrake mounted in this position on a really long handle, eyeballs on track, two turns ahead, and without even looking down, you can access that handbrake very quickly. Boom, boom. It's just like right there, whenever you need it. But you know what? This white grip, I can definitely see that in my peripheral vision against this black screen. It's not even blocking the screen. I can like reach around it. So I'm really liking this. Especially with the white interior. I'm going to visualize any contact that we might have with this panel and verify that once we have fittings on that handbrake, that it can still fit in there as easily as it was going during my little test session. You know, there's a bunch of drifting techniques, but a lot of them are something that happens in a manual transmission car, like clutch kicking, for example. But since this is a single speed car and there's no clutch, then even to test the diff, I need all the help I can get with any available drifting techniques. And handbrake is a very, very important technique and drift initiation and just overall car control. With no engine braking, there's no way to like control your slowdown. But yanking a handbrake handle that's exactly the tool that you need. Although I used that as my guide and it was properly sized to that washer, I'm gonna blow it out to the next size up. So I'm putting a number 8 drill bit through the number 6 hardware hole. You can see that I have these washers welded to it.
Mm-hmm.
Because this thing has like a little lip right there on that shelf.
Mm-hmm.
So in order to touch down on the opposite side of the shelf, we need those washers. 2 M6s per side. I got some M8s, weld nutted. Let's just drop them in. Looks like he wants to be pressed down a little bit. I see threads, man. Extended. All those are semi-tight. Feels rather firm.
Oh yeah.
Hopefully my AC tube goes with it. Mason can get AC on his nuts.
Mm-hmm. Can't neglect the backseat people.
Oh yeah. Satisfying torque. And none of that like snapping sound.
Mm-hmm.
If it's just not ready. This is the point where we can put the AC tube back in. Figure out which way his hump goes. Wire's the other way. Oh, there he is.
Yeah,
so put him on the ding dong.
It's fine, it clears the nut.
Shit, what happens if you don't even take the center console out and you just slip him through this drawer slide hole? And you just pop off the side panels and just use those M6 holes. Like, what's the difference between that result and what we're getting with all this extra hardware and surface area?
It's a fair question, but like, sometimes, even though it's more work, it's like, is it really more work to just pull that thing out and be able to work on it on a bench rather than like you got to take the seats out and you're laying underneath there and you're fumbling with the bolts with your fingertips and you know, is it really harder? I don't know,
this thing comes out pretty easily and you know, one dude can just like fish it out through the back seat. Oh,
nice.
It's just fully good. And just because we're using the IS300 one, this one's getting 3 bolts.